I don't know.
If I was alone when I donated,
I think that can be arranged.
Then it might be all right.
Yeah.
Because it is very flattering.
Yes.
But no money changes hands here at all?
No, no money. I'm sorry, Norman.
Why would I do it?
I don't know. The good thing about it is you don't have to look your best. You know what I mean? It's not a big deal. Can we? Do you want to say that she's going
to
say...
You don't have to take a jar out to dinner.
Right? No.
I'm laughing like I've never seen it. I've seen it. I laugh every time. I can't ever. Now listen, I have a bunch more. Here's another one. One of my very favorite moments. It starts out with Dick Martin, Steve Lawrence, and Edie Gourmet. Okay, watch this one.
If a new study showed that rubbing raw liver on your body would face three times a day could prevent wrinkles, would you do it?
Would Dolly do it?
I'm surprised you've stumbled on her secret. She's been doing that for 10 years.
What will you do now? The raw liver will definitely...
Oh, liver! I thought you said lover!
No. One fine day, you discover that you're the nude centerfold in Playboy magazine. Who'd be more upset, you or somebody else that you would care to specify?
Well, I know that Playboy magazine would be pretty upset. You know, to put one picture in and have a successful magazine go straight into the dumper.
Yeah.
And you know that I did pose nude for Playboy.
No, I didn't know that.
Yes, and those pictures are locked in a vault.
Uh-huh.
They are only used at the suicide center to induce vomiting. You know what Bob Hope says about my chest?
No.
When I've asked what size, he says... 3-4 long.
Ladies, which do you consider yourself to be best at, ladies? Making money, making dinner, or making love? Oh. Goodbye. Whoa.
What are the choices?
Making money, making dinner, or making love?
I understood the question the minute he read it. I understood
that. Yeah.
She's actually very good at two of them because she blends two of them into one.
Which one is that?
She screws up dinner like you can't believe. I don't quite know how to handle
it. Oh, that's funny. That is funny. I got another one for you. Now, this is an April Fool's trick that we played on one of our teams. I want you to watch how the late and wonderful Tody Fields reacts to this, okay? Watch this.
What is your husband's full name? Think about that, ladies. We'll come back in a moment for your answer. There they go. Okay, now, I got to tell you something, fellas. Between you and me and you and everybody, this is April Fool's Day, and we're going to play a joke on the ladies. We're going to give each rooting section $100 right now, right off the bat.
Okay.
And what we want you to do is make up a phony name. Okay. So that when the ladies come on the air and give the answer thinking they know it, you'll groan like they got it wrong, and we'll say, I'm sorry, that's not it. Okay? Okay.
We make up a name?
You make up a name. We'll start with you, Georgie. So make up a name.
Of my full name.
Yeah,
so I have to start with my first name, George.
George, and give us a phony in the middle there.
George, Aloysius. Aloysius is a very nice
George
name.
George Aloysius.
George Aloysius Johnston Jr.
Junior. All right. Now, all right, Tody, for the share of the pod here, what is George's real name?
Rebecca Wells.
No, he's kidding. You know my name. Come on, tell him the name.
What is George's full name?
You know the name. Tell him
George
the name.
George William Johnston Jr.
No.
Tody.
I'm so sorry, Tody.
What happened to Aloysius? You forgot Aloysius?
Where the hell is Aloysius? Was Aloysius. Johnston was bad enough. name is not Aloysius. Where did you get Aloysius?
Tony.
Your mother would do something like that, too.
Tony, we played a cruel trick on you. Today is April Fool's Day. You were absolutely right. And you got $100.
Oh, that's funny. Thank you. Thank you for coming, Bert. Thank you, Bill. Nice to be with you. Thank you all. Thank you. Tattletales isn't the only show that plays tricks on its panel. To tell the truth, did it quite often.
Let us welcome a New York City police detective who is out to trap muggers.
Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is Detective Richard Buggy.
Number two.
My name is Richard Buggy.
Number three.
My name is Richard Buggy.
The votes are in. Will the real Detective Richard Buggy please, sir, stand up?
No! Good job. Good job, team. Marvelous. Let's find out who your imposters are, Detective Buggy. Number two, would you tell us what your name is and what you do, please?
My name is Chris Hart, and my mother is the charming panelist, Kitty Carlisle.
You told me you brought him up to be a nice flower. Yeah.
I called you today and I couldn't find you. Where you were.
Let's go down the line. Number three, now that we've had our fun, what is your real name, please, and what do you do?
My name is Joe Garagiola Jr.
Something to me.
Take that stuff up. Hi.
I want to thank all the stars and my co-host, and a special thanks to all the great game show contestants who, after all, made these funny moments possible. Good night.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for TV's Funniest Game Show Moments. A Mark Goodson television production.
This is David Hartman. Tomorrow on Good Morning America, more on aid to Central America. Also, Raymond Burr, Ephraim Zimbalist Jr., and Telly Savalas. Next week, Linda McCartney and Kirk Douglas on Good Morning America.
Sunday afternoon, Los Angeles meets Philadelphia, and Michigan battles New Orleans on ABC's USFL football. Check listings for games in your area.
We'll talk with Jesse Jackson about
his prize roses and from